Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to see the Corvus OS based on Android version 11, and so guys, let's begin. So as you guys can see, the Android version 11, the maintainer here is Khushang, then the kernel we get here is the Nightblade kernel. And the security patch we get is 5th June 2021, the latest the one we get to see. This is the about phone. This is the settings panel, the home screen normal, as you can see. Nothing here has changed. On swiping right, we get to see the Google feed. This is not the Google launcher. Here the Pixel launcher here is not available. This is something else launcher. I don't know which. And this is the quick settings panel, and currently I am running at 90 hertz. The reason behind it I will just show you afterwards, so watch the video till the end. First of all, looking at the settings here in the system, these are the options, and in the gestures, these are the options: lift to check phone, here is just not working. Then in the system navigation gesture, these are the options, and you can hide the gesture bar from here. The gesture bar length just switch to hidden, and the gesture bar will just hide. Then going back here, this is the settings, the digital well-being, accessibility options and everything. Going to the security options, the fingerprint scanner here is working perfectly fine. No issues with the fingerprint scanner, as you can see. It is a bit slow, but it's working fine, no issues. Then talking about the face unlock here is also working. The app locker here is also available and is working perfectly fine. As you can see, this is how it just works. So the app lock, face unlock, everything, fingerprint scanner, everything here is just working perfectly fine. And as you can see, this animation here is feeling just great. It is something new. So yeah, then going forward, and the sounds and vibration, everything here is also the same. We get to see the option volume steps. You can set it according to you. Then going forward, the phone ringtone, media, and everything here is just the same. Then you get to see the direct sound channel. As usual, just everything here is just same. It is just another stock ROM, like the another ROM custom. Then moving forward to the display options, these are the options. The double tap to wake here is working perfectly fine. As you can see, no issues with the double tap to wake. It works each and every time. So yeah, this is a great thing. Then you get to see the brightness levels and everything, the adaptive brightness, styles and wallpapers. These are these Corvus OS wallpapers available. These are the clock styles available. So yes. Then moving forward, here are the options: the display size, font size, device specific settings. You can turn off the pill style notch if you want to from here. So yeah, you can use it like this, but if you want, you can just turn it on from here, and it's quick, the results are fast. Then we get to see the minimum refresh rate. You can set to 120 hertz. Then moving forward to the battery options, the great thing here is we get to see the thermal profiles, as you can see. And for Battleground Mobile, I have set to gaming, streaming and everything. So these are the profiles available. We will talk about the gaming performance afterwards. Talking about the battery backup we get, so this is the battery drain from 100% to 10%. I got 6 hours and 18 minutes of screen on time, and this was the whole time I was using at 120 hertz refresh rate. So yes, at 120 hertz refresh rate, it's average. It's not good, it's average. And for charging time, as you can see, to charge from 10% to 81%, from 10 to 44 it took 21, and 44 to 81 it took 30 minutes. So yeah, it took around 51 minutes to charge from 10% to 81%. So yes, the battery here, it charges at 27 watts, so the battery charging here is pretty fast. And the 27 watt fast charging here is supported in this ROM. So yeah, this was it for the settings. Now moving forward to the Corvus settings, here are the customizations, the Raven's Lair themes and Raven's desk. In the Raven's Lair, these are the options: the notification gestures and miscellaneous, the lock screen items. These are the options available. Then here are the status bar options, the battery options, clock options, icon manager, and the quick settings. Here are the quick settings customizations available. Going back, the traffic indicators, you can turn it on from here. Then here are the hardware customizations, the buttons, volume buttons, wake device, the navigation bar options, and the power menu. You can turn on the advanced restart from here. So yeah, this was the customizations, and here it is placed up here. So it is difficult to find, like just click on this and now you will find the options. Then here are the themes options, the icon shape you can set, the status bar icons, QS headers, styles, switch style, everything you can just customize from here. So yeah, these are the theming options available. And in the revenue desk, here are the updates. The update here is just not available. I am running the latest one, the Corvus 16.5 Alpha-Centauri. So yeah, this is the latest one I am running. And so now moving forward to the home screen, this is the home screen. Now talking about the quick settings, here everything here is just working. There is a problem in the status bar. As you can see, the Wi-Fi here currently is on, but I am running two SIM cards, so it is showing one SIM card and then it is showing dot. So if the Wi-Fi is on or off, you will not be able to know on the status bar. So this is an issue I am facing with the status bar. Then talking about the quick settings, everything here is just working. Mobile data, VoLTE, LTE plus, like 4G plus here is also working fine. Then the refresh rate toggle here is working. The FPS info here toggle is also working absolutely fine. As you can see, currently I am running at 90 FPS and it is running fine. So no issues with that. With the FPS info, FPS info here is working. The screen recorder here is also working absolutely fine. As you can see, now it has started the screen recording. Screen recording here is working fine. No issues with that too. Now talking about the safety net here, the safety net status has also passed. I'll just show you. So as you can see, the safety net status has passed and the banking apps are running perfectly fine. I am having no issues with the banking apps. Banking apps running perfectly fine. Then talking about the DRM info, let's see. So as you can see, the security level we get here is L1, so no issues with the HD playback. The HD and full HD, you will be able to stream full HD 1080p videos in the Netflix and Amazon Prime, whatever you say, Hotstar. So yeah, this was it. Now talking about the Geekbench scores, currently while shooting the video I have not done the Geekbench and Android benchmark scores, but so here are the screenshots of both these scores. So talking about the performance here, the performance here is just great. No issues with the performance. And talking about the gaming performance also, the BGMI I am playing, BGMI mobile here, the Battleground Mobile India is running perfectly fine. No issues with the Battleground Mobile India, and the gaming performance is even better than the previous ROM, the Dubfest ROM or the Pixel Plus UI. The gaming performance here is better than the many of the other ROMs available. So yeah, if you want to play games, then the Corvus here is a great ROM, but the battery backup here will be just average. And the settings we get to see here by default here is in the graph settings, the smooth plus ultra and the balanced plus ultra. HD at high, HDR here is not available. So yeah, it's smooth plan ultra here is just great. There are no frame drops or any such kind of things. Gaming performance on this ROM here is just great. So yeah, this was it for the Corvus OS. Now talking about the bugs here, first bug I had faced that sometimes the mobile data will just not work. As you can see, currently it is showing me LTE, but sometimes, like when I installed the ROM at that time, I was facing the mobile data was just not working. Currently it is working, it is showing me the LTE sign, but sometimes it was just won't work. And the another issue I had faced is the battery drain issue. I'll show you the screenshot. So here is the screenshot, the battery drain from 65% to 60%, and the screen on time I got was around only 6 minutes. So yeah, this was the issue I am facing, the battery drain issue, that just in just 6 minutes it's just drained 5% of battery. So yeah, this was the issue. This was the only issue, like the mobile data sometimes just don't work and sometimes the battery drain issue. So yeah, this was it for now. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to hit the like button. If you are new to this channel, then please guys subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, then you can ask me in the comment section below or in the Telegram group. I'll meet you in the next one. Till then, stay safe, have fun, and goodbye.